Now, this idea embodies in itself the basic thought of similarity, self-similarity. And it was taken up around 1940 by Kolmogorov and others, but in a very analytic fashion. They produced this marvelous work on K-5/3 spectrum of turbulence, which played such a big role in science and also in my life. But for me, in a certain sense, the K-5/3 was an oversimplification. It was already analytic and too crude, because it assumed that turbulence was homogeneous, that even though there was eddy structure hidden under it, the turbulence was the same at every point. However, as it was pointed out very soon to Kolmogorov and to others, turbulence is anything but homogeneous. If you think of wind, the wind comes in gusts, and you think of a gust, the gust is not just a gust, but it has separated sub-gusts. It splits into pieces. Turbulence has not only a self-similar scaling analytic structure, it has a self-similar scaling physical structure. And the question was how to illustrate, how to represent it. Now, for this goal, I introduced the idea of scaling going well beyond the analytics to the geometry. And that was the foundation of the theory of multifractals, which I mentioned because of mathematical interest. The mathematical interest came second. It was very great, but the most important idea was that these hierarchies were meant to represent the structure of turbulence. And the many techniques were developed. I hasten to say these techniques were developed completely on the basis of a tradition in mathematics. I was not aware of any work in physics proceeding in the same fashion. For the rivers, and say the River Nile, or any of the other rivers, with one exception, which is the Rhine, the structure was very different. What I did was to generalize Brownian motion by introducing fractional Brownian motion. I add again, as I often do, that later on I discovered that fractional Brownian motion, without name, was present as esoterica in one or two papers before my work. Those papers had attracted no attention because, as defined formally, it was not a topic of exciting content. As I defined it, it was simply a translation into mathematical terms of the idea that 7 linear, 7 fat years, 17 of each, 70 of each, 700 of each. And the development of this approach was very different from multifractals. If I had been only, led by analytic similarity, by the fact that the one of ref noise occurs in both cases, I don't know where I would have ended. Because one of the principal lessons I learned from my studies is that generality is, generality for birds. It is not offered by mathematicians when it's interesting. But in general, if I dare say, generality itself takes us away from what we can see and compare and have on our fingers and study in detail. So I certainly studied one of ref noises as one phenomenon, or several kinds of them, including the variation of rivers, and multifractals, a separate thing, even though I had gone from one to the other for the purpose of keeping the one of a character and having something richer. Today, I just finished putting together a book which puts together my papers of the 60s on this topic, and their diversity and their unity impress themselves upon me again. They are all the same phenomenon if you look by this narrow window of Fourier spectrum, harmonic analysis. They're very different phenomena from any other viewpoints. It's a case also where mathematical haste of saying this is almost independent is absolutely terminal. One gets nothing because one proceeds very, very carefully.